Hello, Patrick Walchuk here with Alan Gilman of Dominion Lending Centers, and I've got a question I wanted to pose and have a little conversation about. And Alan, it has to do with an article that came out on Friday, I believe, that some kind of a first homeowners program that was run by the federal government has been canceled. Is that true? Is there no more first time homebuyers program?
That particular program, yeah, Patrick, it was canceled. There is, of course, still a first-time homebuyer savings account where people can put money and save money tax-free and all that good stuff. But the first-time homebuyers program, the idea behind that was to help make homeownership more affordable. It never really hit the mark. The government saw a very low amount of traction with it. Because of the way it was set up, it could have been tweaked, but they opted to cancel it, and hopefully they'll start over with something else. But that one's out of the picture. In the last few years that we've had access to the program, I think I used it once. Once you explain it to the client and they understand the positive and the negative involved in the program, there really wasn't any great incentive to go forward with it.
Okay, great. Thanks for that, because I just wanted to make sure that there was no confusion. That people thought that the first-time home ownership account had been canceled, and that's completely different.
Completely different, and they've done a great job with that. I mean, because there needs to be vehicles available for people to take advantage of to get into their first home. That's there 100%. There's a few different paths forward on the down payment side of it. And we expect we'll see something soon that really fits the need even better.
Great. Okay. Because I kind of like this current program because it's got a couple of unique things in it. One is that I believe you can put $8,000 into it annually per person. Okay. And when you put the money in, the money's treated like an RSP where you get to defer taxes. Mm-hmm. But also when you take the money out, it's like a TFSA. You don't pay taxes on it. And I'm not aware of any other financial instrument that has both of those things built into it. So I think it's pretty cool from that perspective.
I completely agree. It's needed. And I'm glad that it's there. And I hope to see more of those types of financial tools available for people to be able to move forward and transition into owning their first property.
Okay, terrific. So if you want to know more about the First Time Homebuyers Program, this is your guide to call. Thanks for watching.